The first tour I did was called Hiya Mate because I say hiya mate to people. That is the level of thought I put into that whole tour. The second one was called The Following because it was The Following Tour. This one, you know, I sat down, right, and I thought, sit down and actually fucking make an effort, mate. Try and fucking do a show for yourself. And I did. And I sat down and I came with a whole show and another theme and ideas in it and shit like that. And it was called Changed. And ironically, the show's had to change about 5 fucking times. And I'm not fucking doing it again. I'm going back to winging it. I don't give a fuck. Too much effort. Don't like it. February 2020, when I came up with this show, right, what it was meant to be about was the fact that I was fucking minted. I don't want to come across as a show-off, but I was fucking minted, mate. Like, don't get me wrong, I wasn't like Alan Sugar. I didn't have a jet or nothing, but I'm from a council estate, mate. I was out of my overdraft. It was mad. I'd never seen anything like it in my life. It was incredible. I was doing stuff I'd never dreamed of. I was walking around Tesco's, not even using a fucking calculator, mate. Incredible scenes. I wasn't even buying Tesco's malted wheats. I was buying Shreddies, mate. Not even the little one, big box, not even waiting for an offer. Not even one. I was just putting my arm behind the shelf. Fucking get in the trolley. Knew I'd made it. When I got to the till in Tesco, and they were like, have you got a club card? And I was like, fuck off, no. Give them the points. What? You know what? It changed me. I'm going to be able to... The show is called Change, because having that money, it turned me into a bit of a cunt. When you're from a place like me, like when you're from a rough area, I'm looking around the room, most of you don't understand this, right? I think the best people come from rough areas, but when you're from a rough area, you... 100%. There's one fucking rich fella in here going, I thought we were good people, Jane. Apparently the peasants don't like us. Jesus. It's these cunts in the box, innit? When you're from a rough area though, you will have asked this question or you've been asked it. Do you reckon if you got money you'd change? And I've always been like, fuck off, no. I wouldn't change. And you know what? I was fucking incorrect. I didn't even need to become like a millionaire or not. And I got about 10 grand in the bank and I was like, shut up, peasant, don't talk to me. Got a fucking blue tick on Instagram, mate, get away. You don't realise you're a cunt. It's like getting fat. You don't realise you're fat until you're fat. You look at yourself every day in the mirror, you're like, oh, I look all right. And then you see a picture of yourself 2 years down the line, you're like, fuck off, who hit me there? Why did no one tell me I was a fat cunt? That's what happened to me. I turned into a cunt and no one told me. I only realised, right? I've only been driving a few years, me, right? My first ever car was a little Peugeot 108, right? And it was a white one with orange wing mirrors on it, a little ginger mobile, and I loved it. It was a fucking beast. I called him Leo. People used to take the piss out of that car, ruthless, and I didn't give a fuck. Got a bit of money in the bank. All of a sudden, Leo wasn't good enough for me anymore. Didn't even realise I felt that way until I've come out of work one night, right? And I've gone to get in the car. Some lads just walked past and he clocked me, right? And he's just gone, fucking hell, Paul! Is that your bird's car? That had happened before, and I'd defended the car before, but for some reason, on this occasion, I didn't defend the car. I just went, oh yeah, lad, she's got my make, you know. And I was gutted. I was gutted at myself. I was apologising to the car and not on the way home. So sorry, Leo. I don't even mean it. I don't know why I said that. When I smoke weed, I have a little weed brain, like a little voice that wakes up in my head, and he is fucking sound. So I'm sat there thinking I'm a cunt. I'm like, I'm a cunt. Why am I doing that? Why am I trying? I'm feeling dead bad about myself. I had one pull of a joint and he just woke up and went, nah. You're fucking sound, you, bro. And I was like, do you reckon? He went, yeah. You're one of the soundest kids I've ever met, bro. And I was like, well, why am I doing that though? Why am I acting like I've got a make when I haven't got a make? Why am I trying to be something I'm not? He went, nah. That's not because you're a cunt, lad. Do you know what that is? It's because you should have a make. You deserve a make, you, bro. You work hard. And I was like, do you reckon? He was like, yeah, get a make. I was like, nah, it's a bit much. And he was like, get a mech. Trying to forget about it, just trying to watch the telly and chilling that. And he's just in the back of my head like, get a mech. Get a mech. Go on. Couldn't sleep or anything. Just trying to sleep, and he's just in my head like, oh, Lord, won't you buy me a Mercedes Benz? I woke up. And I think I was still a bit stoned, because he's still going on, get a mate. And I was like, fuck it, do you know what? I'll just go and have a look. I'm not going to buy nothing. Just go and have a look. If you shut up about it, I'll just go and have a little look at it. Now, it's always been quite an aspirational thing for me, a Mercedes Benz, and I never thought I'd get there. But when I got to the forecourt, they had one of them little A-class ones outside on a ramp with a big sticker on saying, sale, £4,000 deposit, £279 a month. And I thought, ooh, maybe we can afford a mate. Maybe we've made it. Dream, believe, achieve. And I got a bit of confidence in myself. Didn't even walk a fucking swaggered Conor McGregor style into the fucking... bounces into this make showroom all full of life and that. But Saturday morning, tracksuit on, stinking of weed, right? And that is a mistake. I didn't know it was a mistake because I've never been in there. I've only ever been in a Peugeot showroom. And I'm not knocking anyone who drives a Peugeot, by the way. I think they're very good cars, but it's just a different experience to the Mercedes-Benz showroom. You can walk into the Peugeot showroom on a Saturday morning with a tracksuit on, stinking of weed, and they are very happy to see you. Mercedes, mate, you need an appointment just to stand near a car. It's weird. I've walked in all full of confidence in that. I've walked up to the reception. I've gone, hey, love, can I have a little look at the little A-class one outside? And she's looked at me and she went, have you got an appointment? And I was like, oh, no, sorry, I didn't know I needed one. And her head fell off. She took my name and she was like, but you're not on the system. But you're not on the system. And I was like, I know, I've just walked in. She couldn't believe it. She was looking at me like, the best I can do for you, sis. See, can you see the tables over there? I went, yeah. She went, just have a seat on one of them. And we'll just have to get round to you if we can. Is that how it works? Yeah, I just sit there and hope you can sell me a car. And you would think that would put me off, but it fucking never. Oh my God, that made me want that car so much more. Why? But I was walking to the table thinking, fucking hell, I'm getting this car now. How good are these? They don't even have to sell them. I was looking around the showroom thinking, I wonder how long he's been there for. Like, he'd been there for 3 months, like, oh my God, I hope I get one today. Oh, I miss my kids so much. So she took me to this table, right, and I go to sit down. I had a bit of a to-do with this guy, right? He was already sat there. He's quite a fancy-looking fella. He's a big guy, but he's in, like, a fancy suit, fancy shirt. Yeah, even his pen and his fucking cufflinks, everything about him was, like, he looked expensive, do you know what I mean? Like, he was proper minted. Like, I had a bit of money, but he would always be minted, do you know what I mean? Like, if you had to draw a Tory, you would draw him, do you know what I mean? Like, he had one of them big fucking red gout noses, like he'd only ever had cheese for a steak, do you know what I mean? The way I got brought up is, if you ever make eye contact with a stranger, right, you just let on, all right, mate, all right, and that's what happened, right? I've gone to sit down. He's looked at me, and I looked at him. We made eye contact, and I went, you're all right, mate? And he looked me dead in the eye and just went... I know, just tuttered, and then fucking blanked me, and I was like, eee! And then the woman went, have a seat there, Mr. Smith, and I'll see if I can get someone to come over and talk to you about the A-class. As he said A-class, he's looked back at me again and gone, pfft. Like, I'm some kind of scruffy twat, right? I don't hate many people, but I fucking hate him, right? And I'm sat there just looking at him going, look at me again then, look at me again. You big fucking knobhead. And he won't look at me now, he's just staring straight at Ed. He can feel me, he's just staring straight at Ed, right? This sales manager walks over to him, I clocked his badge, the sales manager walks up and he's very polite and he goes to this guy, how can I help you? Say, he just gets him and goes, follow me, right? And just marches him off to the middle of the showroom where there's this big fucking silver thing right in the middle of everything with the up lights on it and stuff like that. And he's got this poor guy going round his car for 25 minutes. He's under the bonnet, he's round the wheels, he's fucking sits in every seat. He nearly got him the fucking boots. I thought he was going to shag the car at one point, right? Then he comes back down and he sits down, the sales manager's like, what are we thinking? He goes, make me a coffee, right? Just orders him to make him a coffee. And he does, he just scuttles off, goes and makes him a coffee, comes back with his coffee and some paperwork, and he's looking at it going, yes, reasonable, it's reasonable. I'll tell you what, just give me a couple of hours, I just need to run a few things past the accountant, but I think we're good to go. And I was like, ugh. Then I got tapped on the shoulder and I've turned around and it's a young kid called Joe. And he goes, hello, sir, I'm Joe from Mercedes-Benz. I believe you want to have a look at the A-class. I'll take you out to look at it now if you want. And I just went, no. And he looked confused and I was confused. And he's got his little clipboard and he went, oh, sorry, it is Mr. Smith, innit? I went, yeah. He went, oh, it says here you want to look at the A-class. And I went, nah. And I don't think I was still a bit stoned because my wee brain could grab this arm for a second. I went, we want that one. And I pointed at this fucker's car, right? And he looked at me then, mate, because he was like, don't you dare. And I was like, yeah. It's the most powerful I have ever felt in my entire life. I felt fucking phenomenal until I looked at Joe and I saw him looking at me like I was a fucking dickhead because he's clearly seen me driving in a fucking Peugeot 108. He's watched it happen, and I'm sat there in front of him with a tracksuit on, stinking of weed, and he wants to go, fuck off, mate. But he can't because he's in work, so he leans in and goes, hey, mate, you do know that's the S-Class, don't you? I was like, yeah. Didn't have a fucking clue. He goes, hey, it's the grand edition, that, you know, it's got everything on it. I was like, yeah, that's the one I want, yeah. And he was like, have you looked at it? I was like, nah. And he's going, he's looking at me going, mate, are you fucking stupid, right? But he can't, so he goes against the key. We're walking towards the car. I'm trying to think of some intelligent questions to ask him, but I know fuck all about cars. So I just get to it. I opened the door, I sat in it, it was dead comfy, and then he let me turn the engine on. I revved it once, it sounded amazing, and I just went, I'll have it! I knew it was weird because all the way up until that point, he'd be like, hello, I'm Joe from Mercedes Benz. And as soon as I said I'll have it, he dropped all out my full on rough ass scouse. He was like, fuck off, lad, really? I don't even think he's allowed to sell these cars. He fucking legged it to the sales office. He's come back like juggling paperwork and that, right? Drops the papers on the desk, and that is when I seen how much the car was. Fucking 95 grand. And I was like, oh, fucked up here. I'm going to have to leg it. I'm going to have to leg it. Where's the Peugeot? We're going to have to go. We're going to have to go. I mean, we brain pipes up. He's like, but you can't let this fella win. You're going to have to buy it. I'm just going to have to deal with it. I was like, what do you mean? I can't buy a 95 grand car. Are you fucking mad? And he starts getting all persuasive on me. He's like, think about it, Paul. You just had a good year, mate. You just had a good year. You just done an arena, for fuck's sake. I was like, I have, yeah, but I still can't buy a 95 grand car. He's like, but think about it, mate. Your next tour's on sale. It's going to be the biggest one yet. Tickets are flying out for it. It's going to be incredible. I was like, it is yet. He went, so what are you worried about, Paul? 2020 is going to be your year. What could possibly go wrong? And I was like, oh yeah, sign! 2 months I had that car, and then every theatre in the country closed down for about 15 months. And I was like, fucking crippled me, mate. It ruined me. It was the worst thing I've ever done. You think I'm funny on stage? You want to hear me phone fucking Admiral? I'm trying to insure a 95 grand 3 litre beast of a make when I've got 2 years no claims on a fucking go-kart. They think that shit is hilarious. They were passing me around the office and shit. I couldn't see them, but I fucking know I got a standing ovation at the end of the phone call. Joe, what? It's all well and good having an S-Class, it really is. They're lovely cars, but when you can't afford to put diesel in it, it's so shit. I wish that was a joke, but it's not. There's been points in the last 2 years when I've been sat in that car on my driveway. Just unable to move. Just sat there because it's the comfiest place in my fucking house.